What is going on, guys? We are back with another video today. It is about to be week three against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and we get a sub with Prime. Appreciate it, Lemon Cult. Of course, that's a great segue because we've been doing a lot of streams on the Washington football team franchise, of course, live on twitch.tv/Jeromepkr. And if you guys want to go there, hey, maybe do it, follow, I don't know. And while you're doing it, I mean, I've already got you going to a different platform. You might as well like and subscribe and follow me on Twitter, Jeromepkr. You know, link me your PayPal. I'll take some nothing. But, of course, like I said, about to go to week three. The last two games, you know, week one, I've mentioned it a few times, I feel like we were going to lose that game because they just were not stopping their scoring. They had 24 points at half, and then they just died out. I don't know. It is Atlanta. I forgot. Never mind. Now it hit me. How did I not figure that out before? It's obvious. That's what they do. And then, of course, for New York, they just, after maybe the first quarter, it was just all us. It really was. Heading to week three, of course, no breakouts yet, but this is probably the one, right? It's probably the one. Come on. As far as scouting goes, which I do not think we have done any of, are we doing a real class again? I don't know if there's any that are, like, good. In case we don't see one we like, I'm just going to scout a few players here and then save the rest. But yeah, I think I would like to do another class, but I have no idea how accurate it would be. Also, maybe check it out. Probably in the community tab by now. If you're seeing this, Pkr Plays, check out the channel. Just saying. I post a lot of non-Madden. If you are mad at Madden and EA this year like I am, show them you mean business by watching the videos. Our guys are Warriors. Now we're Washington football team franchise. Idiots. Your alliance? Yikes. Player of the week. We had a couple of decent players, didn't we? Dwayne Haskins. Accuracy man himself for once in his career. Gets player of the week early on, week two. Nice. Looking at the team, maybe we make a trade before we play for a pass rusher, because once again, Chase Young is injured, but we haven't had a game where we played without Chase Young, and I'm not going to lie, Porter Gustin, he kind of played well. We don't really have a lot of depth at pass rush linebacker right now, but we do have linebackers that can at least fit the role. Maybe we just drop them back, whatever it may take. As far as the D-line, that's really the guys that are going to have to generate the most pressure now. Ioannidis has always been that guy for us, though. And he has an upgrade point, which is clutch. Cannoneal, been a little 50-50 for us, but he's been laying the boom. And then, of course, Luke Green has been all over the field. I don't know how you even stop him. We have a couple upgrades elsewhere. Let's go with Mr. Reuben Foster, now an 82 overall superstar development player. It's okay. It's a decent upgrade. And then the one I want the most. Normally, I would go with Run Stopper, but Matthew Ioannidis is a beast in the pass rush game. I'm going to give him Power Move, and he will end up getting +2 to Power Move. I appreciate that a lot. Put some over 90. Will that change anything? I don't know, but hopefully it doesn't. Hopefully it stays the same because he's already a god anyways. But this is what the roster looks like going into week three, of course. Worried about Chase Young's replacement, who I think we already mentioned. And yeah, I don't know what to think. I feel like we're going to have to make a trade for a pass rusher after this game is over. Something's telling me. Is that Tristan Wirfs getting all hyped? Okay, dude. I wish we had Tristan Wirfs. I'm just going to be honest. I'm just going to be honest here. Oh, man. But yeah, looking at the offense, everything's pretty much intact. I will say the left guard position has been taking a bit of a hit this season. We put Schweitzer on IR. Hopefully we will get Collegius Emily back soon. And yeah, I mean, there's some injuries on the team, definitely. Specifically, like I said, on that left guard spot. But other than Chase Young, the main playmakers really haven't been hit. And there's the guy we worry about, Tom Brady. Look at those receivers. Look at those targets he has. They are too good. This actually might be a game we underrated a little bit. I know we did mention that this is going to be a team that we're worried about. But, I mean, going into this game, it just doesn't even feel like we're scared of them. And we should be, because they are talented top to bottom. It's a few holes on defense, but outside of that, I mean, they're looking pretty good. All right, there we go. I did not mean to do that. We got an early mistake. A short kick. Porter Gustin, the guy that's very important on the special team. Nice. I love it when they put really important players in the special teams list. And, of course, a holding penalty by Cameron, potentially third-string Brate at this rate, assuming O.J. Howard is healthy, and he appears to be right there. But they're going to use all three on this play, so get near the line of scrimmage, and Neal with an amazing tackle behind the line of scrimmage. Definitely hit him with a little bit of swagger. All right, Green. Oh, wow, he went. Can we not one day, 1 week, please, no underneath plays to the tight end? That's all. 1 week. Underneath look. And oh my Lord, Reuben Foster just went inside of him. And yes, it's that kind of, it sounds exactly what happened. Exactly what I just said is exactly what happened. It should be illegal. Oh my Lord, what is that read by Brady? That should have been a pick. Right, Porter. I know we're asking a lot. That's a screen, and we had him with Neal, but he gets picked up and forced out of bounds, kind of runs out of bounds. Ronald Jones, great pickup, and they will continue the drive. And Luke Green chased him away. Ronald Jones definitely afraid of contact in this one, which is a bit strange. To the outside. Oh, that's a sell. And Landon Collins, this is why you lost your damn captain's badge. Gronk with a huge play all the way down to the six. Oh, Matthew Ioannidis. And Godwin, what a throw to Godwin. We did get a piece of Tom Brady low. And I don't care if it's dirty. I approve of it. Porter, you can play the... Is that a QB spy? What? Yeah, I mean, that's an easy touchdown. Yeah, I should have called a timeout. I was so confused. Defense is just bad. GG league. Inside throw to Mr. Sims. Do not die. Thank you. All right. Smash Diggs. There you go. Going for that outside. We're going inside. Terry McLaurin with his captain's badge. I mean, you already had it, but you know. Yeah, I don't think we should be hit sticking Gronk anymore. Who is this? Gibson. Run a man. Oh my God. Who was that? Winfield. Does he really have that kind of hit power? Well, I mean, I guess it's not really hit power. If it was really hit power, it would have been a fumble, so good hit, but you know, our guy held on. That's the main goal. That's the mango. That is a rough one. Oh, good try. We got to take more shots like that. We're having a really good season this year, and we got to not just be, you know, we can't be like, oh, I'm scared. I don't want to lose our season stats. Now, who cares? If we think we have it, take it. Oh, that could have been picked by Devin, and for a guy that's as athletic as him, I thought he was going to get that pick. I really did. Hovered up the middle. This is a touchdown. Oh, my Lord. Did you see three players block shed at the perfect time? I thought he was walking in naked, which is what I did at Walmart last week. That's not true. It was today. Hubbard to the outside. Pitch. One to beat. Oh, my Lord. If only Hubbard didn't have to beat three players. If your running back is able to take on two players and beat them, it should, in open space pretty much, it should be a GG. It should be a first down, touchdown, whatever it be. But none of those things happen. That's a bad decision, but Hall's big, and he holds on. Hall, the guy we were talking about getting rid of, trading and whatnot, comes up big. Did he catch it? Uh-oh. I will admit, I did notice a little bobble. Let's take a look at that right foot. Butt cheeks count, boys. Butt cheeks count. That's a touchdown. Let's go. What a call. Get in there. He's really going to take this. We going for the pick. Why did we go for the pick? Why? It's Godwin. He's going to make the play. To be fair, I didn't think he was going to. Thumbnail time. All right, Tom Brady with your throwing up the ball and getting lucky self. There goes Ronald Jones for a huge first down. Sweet. Blurner? Hey, I'm a blurner myself. Collins with a huge hit down to the two. Burner. Ah, it was close. I said blurner. That's not close at all. And there you go. Who is it? Keanu Neal. Thompson Brady looking for the score. Not going to get it. And it's probably a holding call. Is that true, Macamac? I don't feel like it is. We will be declining this penalty, of course. Donovan Smith with the hold. Did they get the ball first? Or do we make a mistake? Because why do they have more points than us? Or Daryl, number 88, Patterson. These blockers are slow. Patterson's not going to have a kick return touchdown on this team. Simply put, they are so slow. See how slow they were. Yikes. All right, going to go with a trap play, even though they're ready for it, and they got Vita Vea over the middle, but screw it, Hubbard's fast. Like I said, screw it. Hubbard is fast. What a play by Antoine Winfield Jr. Huge gain of about 16 or 17. Hey, I mean, any flood's worse than no flood. To the outside. Instant timing. Oh, nice little catch there by Sims. Maybe could have went for a rack catch, but I'm all right with it. That's a risky one for most players, not us. Quick throw to the outside. Mr. Hubbard easily gets it, and he will gain about 7. We got him. Hit the throw. We got him. Over top, Terry McLaurin. Why would you even try man coverage against this man? He scores the touchdown and regains the lead. Bit of a shootout. I honestly don't think they can stop us. Only we can stop us. And I just did as much as I could. I am bad with extra points and field goals. I'm just so bad this year. Oh, that was a sick move. Hit him. There you go, Keanu. Keanu Neal with a nice set of plays in this game so far. I like it. Who is that over there? Mike Evans. Darby is not ready for that assignment. And we pushed hard. He tries to cut back right. Cannot get it. The power of teamwork. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Get in there. Keanu Neal. We're talking him down a little bit, and he's doing really well right now. I'm really happy with him. Good stuff, my guy. You can have anything you want. Do I do it? Do I do it? I don't do it. Good throw out of sack. Was going to go to Terry McLaurin. The insides weren't really getting open the way I wanted them to, and ultimately kind of backed off the play. Ross one-on-one, though. Oliver on the inside, and he gains a massive amount of yards down to the 42-yard line. I'm going to hurry up to the line because I wanted to see what they were going to do. We cannot. Yeah, it's good coverage. Good coverage all around. Seems he's the Mr. Beast of our chat. True. Oh, wow. That D-line is ferocious. So far, outside of that one run, Hubbard has been relatively quiet. Hasn't really had much of a chance. Little hook, line, and sinker for Mr. Ross. Gibson could break free. To the outside. Oh, good try by Oliver. Really good recovery by Whitehead, who I just don't know how he makes that play. Regardless, it's a field goal attempt. It's pretty good look. Up and right down the middle, pretty much, for Mr. Dustin Hopkins, I believe, right? You have Matt Gay as a backup, so any more of those missed extra points, and you never know. There hasn't been a process. Gronk is locked down here. Luke Green. That is a very interesting play. I don't know what the running back's doing there. I don't even blame Tom. That's not even Tom's fault. Screw it. Come on, Allen. He's like, oh, now you want me. Keanu with the pop. Keanu Neal's doing his job, but unfortunately, the flats have been a little bad for us in the last several seasons. And so I can't get the play, and Ruben's all over O.J. Howard, but unfortunately, that's going to be another conversion, as it is so easy for them to attack that spot. I'm going to come. Grant Haley on Gronk. I don't know if I like that or not. And how is Brady getting that off? What a throwaway, dude. Matthew Ioannidis locked up underneath throw to Gronk. Far left is naked. O.J. Howard kind of runs it out of bounds. Barely gets the foot down. Got a little more athleticism. You know, maybe turns it upfield. I don't even know. Where am I going? Underneath. Oh, we tried. Troy Apke with the tackle. Troy Apke lost his number as well, which is ultra unfair, but life's unfair, kid. At least you're making millions still. I don't even know if we have him on contract for millions or not. Luke Green had him. He might still be short. That left knee came down kind of quick, and he is short. Third and inches from the 38. This could be a touchdown play for them, but I mean, how else do you stop the ground here? And Ruben, I think, is going to leave him short. Fourth and inches. Are they going to go for this? This is a huge play in the game. They are going to go for the field goal. Their kicker situation is a little rough there, but doable. And a little bit of a late snap in the ball. Barely squeezes back. What a kick. Oh, my. Oh my, is that Dan Bailey? Did you see that thing? What a kick, dude. Maybe slightly more than normal. It's nothing crazy like people are trying to say. Inside to Mr. Terry McLaurin down to the 44-yard line. I want to run the ball more, but any run we have is just like an obvious look for them. It's like, oh, well, this is clearly a two-minute warning. Did not see that coming at all. They're like, oh, it's clearly a run. What are you doing? It's obvious as they come. First and 10 from the 40. Yeah, it's not on a screen, right? I do feel like Gibson gets more play time than Hubbard does lately, though. And Gibson. Maybe we should have just went for the power move. I went for a left. I stepped right. Went with a left cut spin. It just didn't work. It just simply didn't. Terry McLaurin is a tough man to read, so this double move could be the dag. We taking that. We taking that all day. Hold on. Terry McLaurin for his second touchdown of the game. The man is unstoppable. Is it second? Maybe third? With our missed extra point, we might as well go for two here, I believe. You know, we're up by nine. Actually, no, we probably should have just went for the extra point. But either way, go with the pitch play. One. I need a block. Oh, my God. Hubbard is a god. Look at... Oh, no. Justin Ross is injured. Look, he's running off the field. Watch, he's about to get on one knee. No, he's in. He's not looking pretty good here. And that's going to be a sack. Almost a fumble. We're calling a timeout. Porter Gustin. Is Porter Gustin destined for greatness? Damn it. Oh, that's a really good play. No. Okay. We need to really finish these tackles. Do you still have Ryan Kerrigan? Here's the thing. We disrespected Ryan Kerrigan, and we traded him right away. And Green with the knockout. Nice. 3rd and 8. Turned into 4th and 8. We're up by 11. We're about to get ball. Why does Tom Brady kiss his son on the lips? That is a great question. Is that his superstar X-Factor ability? As far as the audibles go, I don't really like it. Let's just run again with Hubbard. Oh, Hubbard got smashed. Yeah, I'm not going to call a timeout. They can keep it. They can keep the drive. And honestly, the fact that they're not calling a timeout is so stupid. But here we are going to halftime with a nice 12-point lead. Defense has played 11-point lead. I thought it was 12, no? Okay, I guess 11-point lead. Yardage-wise, you know, not crazy much more than them. But I will say I feel as if we're more clinical. And we also definitely have more big plays. All right, Cordarrelle Patterson running to the left. No spin move. Cordero's so dangerous. Just doesn't have any help. We're going to audible this to a run because they just aren't ready for the run game. And we will gain about 9 on the play. We're going to hurry up to the line. So once again, they were not ready. They're going to change it up a little bit. Bring them up a little bit more. But we are going to look for Mr. Gibson again. And Risky going to be short of the first down on this one. No, they're going to call it a first down. Good job, Gibson. Bit of a predetermined route there. But as soon as I saw the blitz coming, I knew I had to get rid of it somewhat soon. Inside, Hubbard trying to break a tackle, cannot. Slant look, and he holds on. 2nd and 4 to the 48. I thought there was a chance for a score. I'm not even gonna lie. Like, there is nobody. I don't know who is this Carlton Davis? Because he has... Yeah, it's Carlton Davis. He has no chance. I don't know why you would ever lock Carlton Davis one-on-one with Terry McLaurin. But you should be fired as a coordinator if you do. I know he's a decent player, but the speed difference alone, let alone the actual talent difference, it's just too big of a gap. It's just one misstep like he took, and you're scoring another touchdown. 3 to be exact, I believe. Right, it's 2nd and 7 from the 28-yard line. Tom Brady looking to try and get his team into this. It's going to be a little bit of a short pass, but Ronald cuts it upfield to the 32-yard line. And we try dislocated shoulder. And not even just that, but they actually came in with a late flag and said defensive holding. It was a run call. How can you say defensive holding? I don't even know. But more importantly, Luke Green is out, which is terrible, dude. But I guess Kaliki Hudson gets his chance, the speedster, and we sell. I will say, in general, the linebackers, we kind of just got manhandled there. Dislocated shoulder, though. Dislocations, it really depends on the body part. A shoulder, I feel like shoulders are relatively easy to work with, but I'm not a doctor, obviously. So I really don't know how long that's going to be. And Gronk underneath, I mean, look at him tanking up, like quite literally. I believe he has an ability where he can't be hit stick, so that's why that's happening. Troy Apke on near the line of scrimmage. I don't really like his tackling ability, but he is very fast. Not fast enough to cover that mistake. Godwin, great slant on the inside. The Buccaneers, they still have a chance. Game's not over by a long shot. However, their defense is being absolutely eaten alive at this rate in time. We're going to come with the blitz hard here. And Mike Evans, I believe his first catch of the game. Got to give it to Darby. You know, we kind of put him on an island there, and he did pretty well. And hell, has done pretty well all game long. All right, Grant Haley against OJ. This is the biggest mismatch of their play. And to the outside in Darby. Okay, we gave him some credit. Could not get there in time. Mike Evans, one way or another, was catching that ball. However, maybe had a chance to stop him short. It is Mike. He's strong. He may have just bullied us anyways. Let's go with this play action play because they want to just focus on the ground. Give him something else to focus on. I can't get that across. Oh, that is such a bad overall. That is very bad. Should have held on. Should have, you know, waited. Instead, it's going to be an unfortunate call and potentially a drive ender already. Inside and left a little too far left. That probably should have been picked by Mr. Devin White, but ultimately, it doesn't necessarily hurt them, and it definitely doesn't hurt us. So you don't want a game-changing pick potentially, because if you can take it back, sweet, dude. I got to cover that. Ronald Jones isn't going to get much anyways. I don't know what is wrong with their offense, but it's not very good. Holcomb right down the middle because Ionite is going to clear this out, dude. Damn, he didn't. He gets through there, though, and Scotty Miller catches it, but it's going to be a 4th-and-3. I think you go for this. I think you go for that, dude. Terry McLaurin. We're going to go to Mr. Sims, who will roll over Mr. Jamel Dean for a first down, which I just don't think anyone of Sims' size is going to be rolling over a Jamel Dean because he's quite a large corner. All right, up the middle. Hasn't been successful for us. And Devin White back at it again. Justin Ross looks like a prime target. Hall, I like this look with 4 wide receivers in. I'm going to float this one over to Sims just so he has a guaranteed chance at it. And that will be a massive gain down to the 48. They have not been able to stop the pass game at all in this matchup. And we are obviously showing the successes of that. They're going to press real hard here because they know it's a pass. Or they thought it was a run, but now it's a pass. I think maybe not. We're going to run with Dwayne. No one in sight. Dwayne. Late slide. Kind of pulled the Joe Flacco there. Thank God Kiko Alonso isn't around him, all right? Play action look. That is really good coverage. However, you can't defend a perfectly thrown ball like Dwayne Haskins just put up. That's just ridiculous. Dwayne Haskins is basically unstoppable now. All right, 2nd and 10. Probably shouldn't be passing as much as we are. I hesitated hard. And Josh Oliver with the catch down to the 3. Carlton Davis is going to get benched. Like, he's not going to lose his job, but because there's so many good corners there, he's going to lose the number 1 spot. Running up the middle, Dwayne. Maybe a little ambitious considering we don't desperately need the touchdown, but he almost gets there, so can you really blame us? To the outside, Mr. Hubbard had a nice little 2-point conversion attempt. Like, how do you even react to that? If I was Ninja, I would, like, sue him or something. Touchdown, Justin Ross gets the touchdown. Nice play, perfectly designed. A lot of moving parts on the right side, and then a quick underneath to the big guy. You don't expect him to be the one to run the drag, which is why it's so deadly. Definitely going to have to look at those sliders yet again. Don't get me wrong, the Patriots have been... the Patriots, nice, Tom Brady. The Buccaneers have been a little inconsistent with their play calling, and there you go. Matthew Ioannidis with the sack. Got to give it up to Porter Gustin, though. He's played pretty well, considering. Werfs is no joke, even if he's a rookie. And, oh my lord, Matthew Ioannidis. I do not know how Matthew Ioannidis and Chase Young didn't combine for, like, 25, 30 sacks last season. Get in there. Get in there. Oh my, we got manhandled. And Keanu Fuller, please. They already lost Mike Evans. Let me take Godwin out as well and end their season. I'm just saying. To the outside, Neal. Oh my god, Neal, so much. Just those hits alone are worth it. I don't care if he blows every play in coverage. It doesn't matter. Ooh, this is the matchup we've all been waiting for. Keanu versus Gronk. What a press on the inside. Oh my lord, OJ Howard is filthy. You can use bits if you want to tell Jeromepkr he's mad at Madden. True. Oh no. Inside we get stuck. Wow, Matt. I think it was glitch, right? That's not Matthew Ioannidis. Was that Matthew Ioannidis in coverage? Of course, you see there, though, Tristan Wirfs is injured. So Porter Gustin going against some novice. The athleticism by Ruben Foster there. But, of course, it is Gronk at the end of the day, and he will catch it for a master full gain. Hopefully. Inside. And once again, Ronald does not like first downs, but it works out to his advantage. He gains 9. I mean, it's very unlikely for them to make a comeback here, but I suppose this is the right way to do it. Getting down the field is one way to do it. Oh, he sold hard. Oh, Scotty Miller, dude. That's the guy you want to get a hit on. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Change it up. I can't. Who are we covering? Okay. Oh, my Lord. The in cuts are so hard. He's not even a cut. He just accelerates there. I really hope Luke Green's not injured long. I really don't care about Mike Evans and Wirfs. Inside, and that's what I get for saying that. That's what I get. Damn it. I'm late. What did you miss? Some injuries and an interesting game here. Uh-oh. Ooh. Justin Big Boy Ross barely get in there. Jesus. Who do we find? We got a wide open guy, but Dwayne Haskins has the ever so rare miss. He actually missed very hard there. I mean, don't get me wrong. We shouldn't be passing the ball. All right, Gibson. Oh, good blocking. Almost a block in the back, though. 3rd and 7. That's the Buccaneers game right there. And we can take this to the 2-minute without having to hike the ball. Very close, but it's just fast enough. All right, Hubbard. Right up the middle. Tries a truck. I don't know. I don't even know what his truck ability is. Hubbard on the inside. Vita Vea taken down. Well, I mean, Vita Vea is not taken down. About time to drop out. Hubbard to the outside from the 12-yard line. This could be a touchdown. This will be the dagger. Probably didn't need to take that in. That's a bench. Really good play there, Mr. Chuba Hubbard. Had 2 touchdowns in each of his first 2 games, and then here, only 1, but he still gets one. You know, it counts. It is what it is. There we go. A big masterful game by the offense once again. Defense has been a little bit shaky again, but we also have had, you know, some decent plays that have stopped their drives and ultimately given us a big... Oh, he went right through him like Terminator. But, you know, a lot of big stops that could have been, you know, scoring drives. And it was just enough. I feel like the Bucs had a couple of decisions that just costed them in the game where, you know, they should have went out for it on 4th down. Down by a ton. Just a couple of decisions that could have changed the entire game. But doesn't matter because we win 45-27. Dwayne Haskins, 5 touchdowns, 0 interceptions, 75% completion percentage for Mr. Dwayne. 22 for 29, 365 yards. Hubbard, 13 for 54. Hubbard's really not, you know, it's been shaky, but he has a lot of touchdowns, 5 already. Terry McLaurin. Oh, my Lord. 8 for 206 with 3 touchdowns. He had 2, like, 50-plus yard plays in this game. He was so good. Carlton Davis just could not get it done. Anytime he covered anyone, that was the guy that was open. And, of course, we advance to 3-0. Anyways, that is going to be episode 24 in the books. Obviously, another really nice win. And also, I appreciate you guys watching, as always. Probably will be another stream tonight. Maybe, I don't know, Monday Night Football is pretty decent, actually. But either way, twitch.tv/JeromePkr. Maybe leave a like and subscribe here if you did enjoy. And more importantly, if any of you guys, like I said, know how to make it where my when I'm playing, the screen, like, frame rate and resolution kind of, like, messes up. I don't know what it is. Somebody suggested what the issue could be, and I completely forgot what it was. Something to do with sizing, maybe? I can't remember. No, it might have been refresh rate. Regardless, I gotta figure it out. Anyways, thanks for watching. Hope you guys come back for next video. But until next video, also, video on the second channel, Pierre Plays today. But until next video,